I guess for either of you, how would you just describe how the spring went for you guys?
You want to go first or me?
You go.
I feel the spring went good. You know, for me, I just had to focus on the little details and stuff that, you know, I kind of didn't get down last year. So I'll say overall, it went great.
Sure. Yeah, I definitely have to agree on that. I feel like as a team, we got closer. A lot of moving pieces, a lot of new people on the team, and we just focused on kind of having like a good team culture, like a family feeling in the facility. And individually, I feel like I had to work on a lot of new pieces in my game, mainly running routes, but I definitely got more natural as we were going. So overall, I have a good feeling about the spring. Yeah.
Team culture for both of you guys. What was the reason that you chose to come back to Arizona? What was the main reason? And how was training camp with the new staff?
Just the brotherhood. And like you said, the culture in the facility, you know, it's just all love. Like, I haven't been to a place where you just walk in and you just feel the love. And then the new staff is great. I wanted to give them a chance and see, you know, what type of people they were and stuff like that. And I already had a great relationship with Coach Bobby Wade because he recruited me. He's at the team up north. So I already knew him. So I was already comfortable with that change. But overall, you know, it was great.
Yeah, I never thought about leaving. I love Tucson. I love Arizona. And I still have a lot of teammates that I'm very close that decided to stay as well. So for me, it was never a choice to actually leave. And just Coach Atkins as a person, he's a great coach. Football-wise, but also just as a human being. So being around him, I felt super comfortable from day one, right off the bat. So yeah, I'm still happy with my decision to stay. And yeah, I'm very, very happy overall. Yeah.
Roberto, how would you describe your experience in Tucson?
Kind of all over the place. I'm an old head on the team, as you guys know. I've been here since 2020, COVID year, freshman year. So just moving to the U.S., was kind of wild. Everything hit me at once. But overall, just amazing. Tucson is kind of like the opposite of where I'm from. The weather, the food, everything is different. But I'm still very happy that I committed back then. And I'm still finding out a bunch of new places, a bunch of new things every day. So yeah, it's great out here. I love it. Yeah.
And you're from Germany originally. Yes, sir. How would you describe life back home and what your childhood was like?
So definitely not football, mainly playing soccer growing up. Yeah, just as I said, it's kind of the opposite. The weather is way different. The people are kind of more like private. They're not as open as like Americans out here. So everybody kind of stays to themselves. But I just had to adjust to it. And, yeah, as I said, I like it a lot. Yeah. Yeah, I have family all over the place. I always kind of say, like, I have family everywhere but the U.S. So Portugal, Great Britain, all the way in Africa, Angola. So, yeah, I have a big family all over the place, kind of. Yeah.
Okay, which of the receiver positions were you working the most at this spring?
The Z.
The Z?
Okay. Yeah.
How do you feel that this has worked for you with the rotation that Coach Brandon and Coach Wade have done at the position?
I felt it was good because last year, I just knew one position, which was a Z. This year, you know, I'm kind of older and starting to learn the game a little more. So now I know the Z, F, and X. So wherever they need me, I can go plug and play, like, with no problem. So,
for either one or both, what are the biggest differences and similarities between this offense and the one that you were in, under Fish?
Tight end is getting a lot of love in this play, in this playbook. So that's probably, for me, the biggest difference. We got the rock, yeah, way more than last year. And what I like the most about this offense and kind of like the way we run practice, we rotate a lot, especially in the spring. It's a lot about development. It doesn't matter if you're one, two, or three. No matter if you're on the field or in the meeting room, everybody gets questions. Everybody has to be locked in. And I think that's kind of like more the college approach compared to like the NFL approach last season. Which I love. Everybody's getting a fair chance, and it's a lot about development and getting better overall.
Roberto, how does a soccer player in Germany start playing football?
It was kind of like a wild story. I was doing track and field back home in my high school, and I had a friend who just kind of asked me, like, hey, you want to join me? There's this crazy sport called American football. and there's like an open tryout. And I was like, you know what? Let me give it a chance. And I just fell in love with it, and I just stuck with it. And yeah, I like it. Yeah.
Did you start watching the
game? Yeah, I kind of started watching it a lot on YouTube, kind of like college workouts, a lot of like just NFL highlights, hardest hits. All year, kind of stuff like that, just all over the place. And I just, yeah, fell in love, as I said, yeah.
Noah, what can you tell us about the progress that these two have made?
Oh, those two, they're special. And it goes for the whole group. This team's done a great job, and it's a lot of credit to Coach Brandon and the coaches. But these two especially have made big strides. Considering we lost two big guys at their position, Jacob Cowing and Tanner, these two have stepped up big time. And you can see the confidence growing. You can see our relationship growing. It's awesome to see.
Where do you think the offense has grown the most this spring?
I think a trust factor, and from the coaches to the players, and players between players. And we knew it was going to be a little rocky coming in with a new terminology, a new scheme. But like I said, the coaches did a great job kind of helping us in a lot of ways on and off the field. And I think we finished on a good note.
How do you think the spring and the last 5 weeks, how do you think it sets you guys up for next year?
It's big time, because this is the first time and kind of the only time before fall camp that we get to be on the field with the coaches. So getting their coaching, seeing their kind of points of view and what they're looking for in each play, it's real big in that phase, and then kind of the chemistry between the guys.
It's awesome.
From running out, they were here 40 minutes early, the Zona Zoo and the fans. So they showed up tonight. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the show. But man, you guys are the reason we do it. You guys are a big reason why this team came back. So we appreciate it.
When do you guys get back on the field, for player and stuff, and how does that kind of work?
Yeah, so we'll be gone for most of May. We'll be back in June. And I think right when we get back, we're in summer workouts and summer player run practices. So a good little break to kind of get reacclimated, and then it's go time when we get back in June.
And by player run profile, do you guys designate someone who is like the coaches that are running these things, or is it just a total collaborative effort?
It's a collaborative effort.
You know, how is T-Mac doing, and what's it been like to not have him out there?
He's doing good. Everything is going well with him. I'm still in great spirits, but like I said, these two, along with a lot of other guys, kind of stepped up. You saw Rex Haynes today, Devin Hyatt, Brandon Phelps. So you could go down the list from our skill guys that stepped up from receivers to tight ends. So obviously, like I said before, not having T-Mac gives room for a lot of people to kind of step up into that role, and they did a great job doing so.
Last question.
How was it for you adjusting to that? Because you're so used to having him out there, playing in high school and college together, and now having that moment where he isn't out there.
It's difficult from a friend perspective, because this is kind of the first time that I've been on the field without him. Obviously, he played the freshman year without me, so this is kind of the first time the tables turned. But as from a player, it hasn't been too difficult, because, like I said, the team and the coaches kind of having my back, stepping up in a lot of ways, winning their one-on-ones, trusting. Giving me the trust to be able to give them the ball, and they're winning when I need them to.
Thanks, guys. That's our time.
Thank you, guys.